This is how GABA can help you face your fears. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about facing your fears with GABA. GABA is an inhibitory neurotransmitter, which means that it slows down or shuts off or prevents from firing neurons in your brain, and it's available as a dietary supplement. In the last episode, I talked about how 800 milligrams of GABA has been used to enhance decision-making under pressure. In this episode, I want to talk about a study that showed that 100 milligrams of GABA could reduce anxiety and help people face their fears with less of a negative impact on their stress response. So in this study, which I'll link to in the description of the video, in this study, they had volunteers take 100 milligrams of GABA. Generally, you take GABA on an empty stomach, and you see the real impact of it in these studies is looked at 60 minutes later. And what they found was two things. Number one, the brainwave pattern of these volunteers who took GABA compared to a placebo, the brainwave pattern was one that you would expect from lower effort focus and less anxiety. Then they had subjects who were afraid of heights, and they had them cross a long suspension bridge so that they were walking, exposed to, not just exposed to height, but walking across this bridge. So that when they're in the middle of the bridge, they're sort of trapped in this high anxiety off the ground position. And what they found was that if they took the placebo instead of the GABA, their IgA in their saliva, which is a part of the, which is an antibody made by your immune system that is considered protective. So it's good to have a lot of this IgA in your saliva. It means that your immune system is strong. The IgA in their saliva, if they got the placebo, went down when they were on the suspension bridge, meaning that their fear of heights was activated. That caused a stress response that tanked their immunity. But when they had the 100 milligrams of GABA first, their IgA in their saliva remained higher, which means that they may still have been afraid of heights, but whatever that loop was, it didn't result in the tanking of the immune system. So probably the GABA helped tame the fear response. So the fear is still there, but it tamed the stress response so that the stress response didn't get out of hand and didn't tank the immune system. So if we generalize from this study, perhaps this means that if we're exposed not just to fear of heights, but to things that we're afraid of in general, if we need to face a tougher than normal situation, a supplement of GABA might help us face that situation. The last study I talked about in the last episode used 800 milligrams, so I would not be afraid to go above 100 milligrams for this purpose, but 100 milligrams is what was used in the study. So I would say 100 to 800 milligrams of GABA in the 30 to 60 minutes before you start facing something that you're afraid of may help. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.